Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thank you for being here. So again, the format for everybody watching is you get a minute to introduce yourself, and then we've got a couple questions.
All right. So my name is Rob Block. Thanks a lot for having me here, Planned Parenthood. I'm a Houston firefighter. I've been a firefighter for 3 years. I got my education at the University of Houston, where I studied history and Mexican American studies as an undergraduate, and got a master's in social work. I was able to do an internship with Representative Jessica Farrar in 2015, and as Ms. Trevino discussed, Representative Farrar is a champion for women's rights and for women's reproductive rights, and was chair of the Women's Health Caucus that session, and was proud to play a small role, small supporting role in that work. Let's see. So I'm happy to continue to be learning more about this issue, and I would love to build on the foundation that Representative Farrar started to advocate for reproductive rights and also for reproductive justice, and make sure that abortion access is something that becomes easier instead of harder, as has been the pattern since the Republican dominated legislature has come up with a new crazy idea every session for as long as I can remember.
So we'll kick it off with the first question. In what ways have you personally and professionally shown support for and been involved in the fight for expanded reproductive healthcare access here in Texas? And then the second part, do you want me to wait or do you want me to give it all to you?
That would be, yeah, why don't we break into this one.
All right.
So as a student at the University of Houston, I was very involved with a number of different activist organizations, and sort of partnered a lot with the Student Feminist Organization, which did a lot of work supporting Planned Parenthood, attended demonstrations, countering protests by anti-choice groups at the Planned Parenthood facility that's really close to the University of Houston, and also groups that came onto campus to push very flawed, very ridiculous anti-choice agendas. And then as a legislative intern, got to work with Representative Farrar and try to understand a little bit of the legislative landscape and proposed bills that did not pass to expand women's reproductive rights, but were successful in stopping, as you said, some of the, not all, but some of the, many of the really terrible anti-choice bills that were proposed.
And the second part is, how have these issues impacted you personally, and what experiences have shaped your perspective about your support, and hopefully how you'll continue to support the organization?
Let's say the attack on Planned Parenthood are the same people that are pushing a white supremacist, sexist, transphobic, homophobic ideology that negatively impacts people all over this district and all over the state of Texas. So the same ideas that are hurting Planned Parenthood and women's reproductive choice are hurting people like Rosie Jimenez and Alicia Booker as well.
Great, thank you for that response. Next question. During the 2019 legislative session, extremist lawmakers pushed through SB to ban local government entities from partnering with Planned Parenthood and other abortion providers, including community colleges, cities, counties, and public health departments. Local governments are playing an increasingly vocal role in reproductive rights, as we've seen with proposed bans in small towns across Texas. If you were elected, would you author a bill to repeal SB 22, and how would you be a champion for local access?
I would be delighted to author a bill repealing SB 22 and or co-sponsor with other folks. I think that the efforts, you know, there are examples in Houston of the Harris County Health Department distributing information about Zika to people that use Planned Parenthood clinics, so we need to be looking at more partnerships between local agencies and groups like Planned Parenthood. The legislation is specifically targeted at Planned Parenthood, and you know, it's something that I would love to champion and do everything I can in the legislature and as a use my platform to push for changes to that and to allow more collaboration between Planned Parenthood and public agencies.
Okay. And I think we still have a little bit of time. So do you have any follow-up questions?
So as I talked about before, often trans health is very much connected directly into reproductive justice, with Planned Parenthood being the only competent and affirming provider in many cases. How would you push to ensure that continued attacks like SB 22 and we could go on and on and on how would you ensure that trans people are not forgotten in policy and legislation and are also protected as we're protecting the rights of all people that need this sort of public access?
That's a great question, and I think the people that are pushing like a reproductive justice framework are really trying to sort of draw the connections between it's not just a women's right to, you know, Roe v. Wade gives women the right to access abortion, but if you're not talking about abortion access for all people that need it, you're not reaching all the people that need those services. So I think groups that are pushing that, it's extremely important. I'm a firefighter, EMT, and we get 1 month of training in how to be a medical professional and no training in how to deal with trans folks, and that's something that I know some people in the EMT field are pushing for. So there are a lot of areas of medical care that need a better understanding of how to deal with the diverse populations that we have in Houston and Texas.
Fantastic. Well, thank you for that education about EMT services and education. Super important. We want to thank you so much for your time, and thank you for being here.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you.